The next Dragon Ball Super Arc. With the heart-pumping conflict against the new and mighty Super Saiyan Broly now over, another adversary is knocking at the door of our Saiyan heroes. He is unlike any adversary that the Saiyans have come across thus far. There is an enemy with an existence you haven't seen. His whole purpose in life is to destroy and demean. The things you cherish will be taken away, and the hope you once had will go astray. His desires no one will understand. His action will create an untold wasteland. There will be moments when you are deceived. He will usher in a time when all will become naive. In life, there are all manners of pain and sorrow, but they all pale in comparison to Moro.
Here at Nerdler.com, we want to start this new year with a blast, and so we decided to introduce it with this awesome video. We're going to give you a brief insight into the new threat that's coming up in the next big Dragon Ball Super saga. Don't forget to like and share. Enjoy! The new Dragon Ball Super manga has come out, and it has introduced a new and ancient threat that is beyond old. I mean really old. You could say as old as dirt itself, like 10 million years old. This new villain is named Moro. And just like all the other villains, he's bad. A bad guy. But on a whole new level. He isn't just a fighter, but a freaking magician. No, scratch that, a wizard. Magicians do tricks, and they're partially sane. Wizards, on the other hand, are complete lunatics. Take Babidi and Bibidi. But he's on a different league. 10 million years ago, Moro fought the South Kaioshin and the Grand Supreme Kai at the same time. Which is pretty impressive, given the fact that Kid Buu had difficulty fighting the South Kai alone. This battle took place on the moon somewhere in a galaxy. From what we've seen, Moro has the ability to influence celestial bodies and use them as weapons. He took control of passing comets and willfully subdued them to be his missiles and launched them directly at the Kais, spraying them with a barrage of comets, rendering them to exhaustion. Just when you thought it couldn't get worse, Moro manifested a new ability, the ability to not only destroy a planet and its star from a great distance, but also able to absorb and consume the planet's life force and everything on it, converting it into energy to where he eats it and gets a major power boost. This causes Moro to have no power limit, making him astronomically stronger every time he does it. He's exceedingly strong without his magical abilities. With them, he's near impossible to beat. No one had the ability to kill or beat Moro. The Grand Supreme Kai saw this and resorted to his last attack. He conjured up a significant percentage of his god power to not only separate Moro from his magic, but seal him up in the process. This technique sentenced Moro to an eternal prison. But like all good things in the DB universe, nothing is ever truly imprisoned. 5 million years after that event, Majin Buu was awakened. When Buu went on his rampage and absorbed the Grand Kai, it broke the seal that was keeping Moro dormant. The only thing that can stop Moro is currently residing in Fat Buu, the God Sealing Power. But Buu is currently asleep in this chapter, and cannot be woken by anyone until he decides to get up. This causes the Galactic Patrolman to implore Goku and Vegeta to join the Galactic Patrol and go on a mission to hunt and capture Moro. Goku then attempts to lock onto Moro's energy signal, seeking him out throughout the universe. When he does pick up an energy pattern resembling that of Moro, Moro becomes instantly aware of him and lets Goku know he's fully aware of what he's doing, which means Moro has some powerful voodoo in his arsenal. Man, we cannot wait until this thing comes out in anime form in the next couple of months. Can you? What are your thoughts? Tell us in the comment section. This was an interesting video. If you like this video, be sure to like and share it with your friends. Also, be sure to check out our store, nerdlert.com, for some cool anime merch. Until next time, you wonderful people, see ya! No, wait, we can't end it like this. Not when the newest manga chapter of Dragon Ball Super has just come out. Chapter 44 shows you more of an insight into Moro's history and purpose. After Goku realizes that Moro knows he's tracking him, the Saiyan concludes that this villain doesn't seem to be all that strong. He noted that there was an underlying ominous sensation when latching on to Moro's energy. It was unlike anything he had sensed before. It was as though he was feeling the pain and screams from an untold amount of people, to the point that it terrified him. The reason behind that feeling was quickly revealed. It was the victims that Moro had absorbed. Remember a few moments ago, we stated that Moro has the ability to absorb and consume a planet's life force and everything on it. Every living thing that he had absorbed is tormented and living through him. These souls are the driving force behind his power. They are the reason why he has lived for so long. For 5 million years, he was held captive as a prisoner in one of the Galactic Patrol top security prisons. An ounce of his magic slowly came back after Majin Buu broke the God-sealing power a few years ago. With that, he had enough power to break free from the Galactic prison. This is where Frieza's rogue soldier comes in. Even though Moro garnered a minuscule amount of his magic, it was in no way comparable to the abilities he once had. The soldier informed him of 7 magical balls that has the ability to grant any wish. Such things weren't around in his time. With the desperate need to propagate his original power, and the soldier needing someone strong to bust out of the prison, they both allied and headed directly to the new planet, Namek. Even though this chapter doesn't state what wish Moro wants, we assume he wants his full magic back. The ex-Frieza soldier intends to use the Dragon Balls to create a planet where he can hide from Frieza. It is important to note that Moro has the ability to find life on planets anywhere in the universe. That was the reason why he was able to locate the untold location of Namek. After sensing the direction of Moro's energy, Goku determined the villain was heading to Namek and used instant transmission to get there fast. As the Saiyans landed on Namek, both Goku and Vegeta instantly see the spaceship from afar that Moro and the soldier are currently on. Goku urges the Nameks to run far away and take the Dragon Balls with them. While that is happening, Moro emerges from the ship and confronts the two Saiyans and realizes the spectacular power level from the one who located him, Goku. Moro's attention is briefly distracted. He senses a young Namekian child hiding in one of the small houses and uses his telekinetic magic to draw him out of the house and directly to his hand. While having his hand around the neck of the boy, he proceeds to absorb the life force from him. Before he could complete his absorption, he is interrupted with a swift kick by Vegeta that causes the villain to release his hold on the child. Vegeta then goes Super Saiyan and charges directly at the monster, but Moro easily evades every attempted attack with ease. Moro jumps back at a distance and tempts the Saiyan to charge again. Vegeta gives in to the monster's ploy, but this time, Moro uses his telekinesis on Vegeta, causing the Saiyan to smash violently to the ground, to then be lifted up in midair, to be smashed back down again, and then flung directly into a small hill at terrifying speed. But among the smoke and rubble, the Saiyan initiates his Super Saiyan God mode and easily shrugs off the attack and dashes towards Moro at haphazard momentum. He lands a punch, but Moro blocks it. He throws a kick and lands a direct hit to the face, which causes the goat beast to be pushed backwards. Being surprised by this, Moro uses his telekinesis again and uproots a tree from off the ground and launches directly at Vegeta. The Saiyan easily destroys it with a flick of his index finger. Vegeta declares that he is unimpressed with Moro's attack and incites him to do something he has never seen before. Because of this, Moro decides to get serious and removes his cloak and says, "You hoped to witness my magic. As you wish then." Leaving Vegeta with a somewhat perplexed and curious look. Oh. And that's the end of that chapter. If you like this video, you know what to do. We're leaving you now. Later.